Hey guys, in today's video I will show you how you can design those cool neumorphic style animations in Figma. You can create them on your own in just a couple of minutes. You don't even need to install Figma. Just go to their website, register and create a new design file. It's a really cool way to showcase your designs and to improve your portfolio by introducing movement and action feedback to it. I'm using different triggers for the transitions you are seeing on the screen. So if you want to learn how to design it yourself, keep watching and let's start right now. Primary feature that allows us to create animations like this is Figma Smart Animate. I will explain how it works in a moment. First, we need to create a new design file. As you can see, I already have the designs in mind, but I did it for the purpose of the intro and I will show you how to design everything from scratch. We need to start from the creation of a new frame. Just drag and drop the size that will be convenient for you. And now let's change the background to the dark tone of gray, like this. Let's create our first shape. This will be a button. I'm following the 8 pixel grid principle in my designs, so the size of every component will be divisible by 8 or 4. Let's round the corners of the button to 25 points and copy the background color. As you can see, our button kinda disappeared. Don't worry. This is one of the principles for achieving neumorphic style in interface design. Now we need to create an illusion of the elevation by adding drop shadow to the layer. Let's set X and Y distance for the shadow to 6 points and blur to 32. Also, let's increase the opacity to 35%. Next crucial component for achieving a neumorphic style is the second shadow created in the opposite direction. So let's set X and Y distance to minus 6 points. Blur is the same, and now we need to change color to white and slightly reduce the opacity in comparison to the first one. 10% should be fine. This is the core principle for this style of UI design. As you can see, we have this nice elevation going on, mimicking 3D. I'm using the Iconify plugin for the icons today. If you don't have it, just go to the plugin section of Figma, search for it and add it to your account. I will be using Material Design icons, since they are free to use. Once you have an icon that works for you, just drag and drop it into your frame. Let me increase the size of it to 48 points with the constraint proportions enabled. Let's align it nicely to the middle of the button. Now we need to add text for the button. I'm using Roboto font and again align it to the middle. To differentiate the icon and highlight the active state, I'm adding a linear gradient to it. I'm using previously prepared colors for it, but you can use whatever works for you. That looks nice. Let's copy the button and reduce its width so it will create this rounded square. To further highlight the active state of the button, I will add a second set of the shadows, but now inside instead of outside and in reverse order. Darker one on top, lighter on the bottom. Let's set the distance to 4 and 4, blur to 16 points and opacity to 10%. Looking good. Now add another one with similar parameters, but with white color and 5% opacity. Awesome. Let's adjust the distance a bit. Now we need to copy the second button and align everything. Let's add the rest of the icons for notifications, user profile and settings. You can add whatever icon you want, but I'm using those for this tutorial. We need to increase the size, align them and change their color. To create the animation, we need to copy the frame for each action. My goal is to create animation for each of the icons, so we will need 3 copies of the frame. Let's focus on the first one. For my animation, I want for the button to change shape to full circle and to increase its size. I also want the icon to become bigger and change color to the primary gradient. we can copy the style of any layer to apply it to other elements. A really neat trick and a huge time saver, especially with neumorphic style. As you can see, it changed the properties, so we need to increase corner radius again. Let's also copy the gradient. You can also do it by saving it to the local style library in Figma. Now we have our first hover state and first frame for our animation. We need two more, so let's repeat the entire process and speed up a bit. We have a dedicated frame for every interaction. Now we need to switch to the prototype view and apply the desired transitions. I have two prototype flows in my project already. So before I do it, I need to create a dedicated flow for this. Now we have a starting frame from which the prototype begins. We need to select a layer that will be our trigger, and by dragging this little circle, we are selecting our target frame. Now we can define our interaction details. So I want the action to trigger while I'm hovering over the button. And for the animation, I'm using Smart Animate with Ease In and Out Back, because it's the smoothest of them all, with 250 milliseconds of transition time. Now we need to repeat the process for all of the frames. Let's see how it looks. For that, we need to hit the play button at the top right corner of the screen. I need to switch view to flow 3. It looks awesome, but I see a small problem with alignment, so let me quickly fix that. Let's switch back to the design mode. Now, I need to move it to the left. Okay, now it's perfect. And there you have it. Let me just adjust the view so you will see it more clearly. Really cool, nicely looking animation of neumorphic style navigation. Now, let me shortly cover the other examples I showed at the beginning of this video. The general principle is the same. But for the slider, I have a different action trigger, which is on drag. I use the reversed gradient and I have changed the position of the slider knob. For the switch, I'm using on-click action. And for the home button transition, I first use the while hovering trigger and the on-click on the second frame. What is crucial for you to remember is that in order for the smart animate feature of Figma to work correctly, you need to have the same names for the layers that are changing between the frames. If you don't, then you may end up with the weird animation errors. To avoid that, it's best to copy-paste the frames that you intend to animate. And if you have elements like icons changing to different icons, make sure to give them the same names. Thank you for watching. I hope you like it. If you do and want more tutorials like this, let me know in the comments by posting Figma. See you guys in the next video.